सो ओके सो टुमारोज क्लास वी विल डू द रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट. टुडे लेट अस स्टार्ट विद सीक्वेंशियल सर्किट. सो इन सीक्वेंशियल सर्किट, हाउ इज अ सीक्वेंशियल सर्किट फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डिफरेंट फ्रॉम अ कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट. सो आई हैव टोल्ड यू व्हाट दैट इन अ कॉम्बिनेशनल सर्किट आउटपुट एट एनी टाइम इंस्टेंट is dependent on your input at that particular time instant. Okay, so output is not dependent on your past outputs. So such kind of circuit where your output is dependent only on the present input, such kind of circuit is known as combinational circuit. And we have seen few combinational circuit that are what? That are your decoder, encoder, then multiplexer, demultiplexer. Okay, we have seen all those things. They are what? They are your example of combinational circuit. Now next is what? Very important. So this subject is very, very, this topic is very, very important. Each and every year questions have been asked from sequential circuit, conceptual question. So combination circuit, combination circuit, what do we mean by combination circuit? Sorry, sequential circuit, what do we mean by sequential circuit? So a sequential circuit is basically combination of a combinational circuit along with a memory element. So when we have one memory element, the output of sequential circuit, it depends on present input as well as past output. Okay? Past output. Now output of this sequential, this combinedly combinational circuit plus a memory element, it is what? It is your sequential circuit. Now sequential circuits have the ability to store or retain past values also. And here your output at present state is a function of input at present state along with your past output. So one by one we are going to see combinational circuit. Okay, one more aspect I want to discuss. Combinational circuit are open loop circuit. Okay, open loop. So I hope that you people know what is open loop, that there is no relationship between output and input. Whereas your sequential circuit, it is your feedback circuit. Feedback circuit means what? There is some kind of relationship between output and input. Okay, present output and past output. Okay, that I should be saying very precise. Okay, so basically sequential circuits have the ability to retain memory. Okay, retain memory. In combinational circuit we don't have that ability to retain memory. So obviously if we are retaining something, that means there should be some memory element over here. So one by one let us see the memory elements over here. So this sequential circuit chapter, it will be totally about this memory element, means what are the different kinds of memory elements and all those things. So the first memory element that we have is what? It is called as your latch. So latch is what? It is a simple cross coupled gate. So cross coupling means what? You can see one of the input, if this is first NOR gate, this is second NOR gate, this is first AND gate and this is second AND gate. One of the input of this NOR gate is latched to the output of this second NOR gate, and one of the input of this second NOR gate is latched to your input of the first NOR gate. So this is what? This is known as cross coupling or gate. So latch can be constructed either using NOR gate or it can be constructed using NAND gate. Okay, so one by one, let us see basically what is your NOR latch, what is your NAND latch, and let us try to understand how basically it retains your memory. So before going, see, there are few output states of the latch or flip-flop that we need to know. Okay, so what are the output states that we have? So before going into output states, let me define what are the inputs, what are the present state, next state of your flip-flop or latch. See, this A and B, they are the input of latch. So here I have taken NOR latch, you can even take NAND latch, it doesn't matter, everywhere this concept will be same. So A and B is what? A and B is your input. Now this Qn, Qn complement. So Qn is what? It is your present input, sorry, you can say present output or even say present state and Qn complement, it is your complemented present output or your complemented present state. Okay, complemented present state. And what about, means these are your past output. Okay, these are your past output. I am writing present, but this implies that these are your past output. Okay, past output. Now next is what? Qn plus 1. So this is basically your next state, or you can even say it as your main output, main output. And Qn plus 1 complement, it is your complemented next state or your complemented main output. Okay, main output. Okay, so any means this is your what? This is your present output, or you can even say your next output. Okay, is this concept clear? So this is the way actually we define them, that present output means that what is the state at the current time, and next state means what will be the next state. Okay, what will be the next state when we apply the input. Okay, what we apply the input. Present means what? Present means the past value over here. We have defined it like this. Okay, so any doubts in doubt in this? So let me know in this terminology, any doubt? Okay, so any doubt? So now let us define what? Let us define the output states of latch and flip-flop. So first is what? First is your set state. So set state, we will say basically this latch or later on any flip-flop, it will be in set state. It will be in set state. Am I audible to you guys? Am I audible?
Yes,
then
sir.
Why are I? Yeah, so are we understanding the concept?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so set state means what? Basically, it is the output configuration of latch, or later on we are going to see flip-flop. Okay, so set state means what? Whenever the output of latch or flip-flop, your next state or main output is equal to 1 and complemented next state is equal to 0, this is known as what? This is known to be your set state. So this implies that the latch or flip-flop is in set state. Okay, set state. So this is your set state whenever this is 1 and this is 0. So at the moment I am not discussing for what input AB this will be 1, 0. I am just telling that whenever this output, this normal next state output is 1 and complemented is 0. From now on I am going to say this as next state, okay, and this as complemented next state. So whenever the next state is 1 and the complemented next state is 0, at that time we call it as set state. Okay. So now next is what? Next is your reset state. Reset state, what happens? In reset state, if your normal next state is equal to 0 and complemented next state is equal to 1, then the latch or flip-flop is said to be in your reset state. Okay, it is said to be in your reset state. Now third is what? Hold state. Now what do we mean by hold state? Hold state means whenever your next state, normal next state, is equal to your present next state and your complemented next state is equal to present complemented next state, complemented state, then it is known as hold state. That means what? If for some input we get this as Qn and this as Qn complement, then we are going to say what? That this is your hold state. That means what? Your latch or a flip flop is retaining its past state. It is retaining or just storing its past state. So this state is known as what? This state is known as your hold state. Now one more state we have. Can anyone tell me what will be that state? Intermediate. Yes, very good. So fourth state is what? It is not intermediate we say. We say it as your indeterminate or invalid state. Okay, invalid state. Now what is this? Now for some input configuration we are going to see now that Qn plus 1 will be equal to Qn complement, sorry, it will be equal to means Qn plus 1, this will be equal to Qn complement. Okay, Qn plus 1, it will become what? Equal to Qn complement. That means what? Your present state, sorry, your next state, your normal next state is becoming same as what? It is becoming same as your complemented next state. So this cannot happen because they are what? They are complement of one another. So if one of them is 0, another should be equal to 1. So this is never possible. So this is known as what? This is known as indeterminate or invalid state. Okay, invalid state. So don't worry if you are not understanding at the moment, just note it down. Then one by one I am going to show you what is happening. And there is one more state. Can you guys tell me what will be that? It will be toggle state. So this we are going to see in your JK flip-flop and T flip-flop. So toggle state states that if for some input configuration your normal present state is equal to the complement of your past state, or if your complemented next state is equal to present normal state, then this is known as what? This is known as your toggle state. So both of the statement, they basically mean the same. If you take complement both side, so you will get the statement. Okay. So toggle state, it is better to write like this, that if for some input configuration, if our output looks like this, then it will be known as what? It will be known as your toggle state, that your flip-flop is in your toggle state. So note it down very quickly, and if you have any doubt, let me know.
So,
yes, tell me.
Sir, the first three states, even except fourth, okay, isn't it obvious that the input will be 0 and 1? Then why we named with a different names the states? Why we named that?
Later on, we are going to discuss that. Why this is named as set state? Why this is named as reset state? Basically, they are all used in what? They are used in storing something or counting, counter operations, okay? So where there we need to actually set the flip-flop or reset the flip-flop, okay? So why the name came as set state or reset, that I am going to tell you. See, basically you can understand over here that your normal output, okay, it is going set. Set means what? It is going at a higher state compared to the complement state. So that is why it is known as set. Over here, it is going at a lower state compared to this one. So that is why it is known as reset. Reset means what? That you are going to a position from where you have started. And usually in counter, we assume that reset is what? 0, 0, 0. Okay. So when we study up counting, down counting, at that time, this will be very clear that why this is called as set and why this state is called as reset. Okay. Any doubts other than this?
Hello.
Yes.
Reset and set also can work like at start of some programming is already fed into some machine. We set the state and it works, and if we want to again make the machine move back to the original state, then we choose the reset state, such buttons.
Yes. See, I will tell you, when you are learning English, okay, when you are learning English or whenever you are learning even mathematics, means directly you don't go and start solving all this thing. Okay, first you learn what is 1 plus 1, you learn the table of 2, table of 3. Now this is incomplete latch, this is not the complete diagram of latch. Okay, let me be very precise with you, very honest with you, this is incomplete diagram, circuit diagram of latch. Now, if I feed 4-5 inputs over here and tell you that this is preset, this is clear, this is that, you won't be able to understand. So, at the moment, you just keep it as simple as it is. Later on, give me just one class, okay, one more class or two class at the most. You will be seeing that you are getting each and every concept that why this is set, why this is reset, and means basically why this is going, means what is the physical significance of set state and reset state. Okay, so Piyush, you will be also getting your answers when we discuss counting. Okay, counters, asynchronous, synchronous counter. Okay, is that clear? So at the moment, just understand this much. Okay, fine. So now SR latch, now this might seem very simple. Okay, some of you might think that sir is teaching a very simple thing, so this is not necessary, but believe me, this will be very necessary later on. Okay, so first is what? SR latch using NOR latch. So this is what? This is your SR latch. Now why the name SR? I will tell. So S stands for set and R stands for reset. So basically this is set reset latch. This is set reset latch. Now if you are able to make one diagram after another, it will be helpful to you later on. Okay, because I will be drawing in the same diagram. Okay, so what can be the possible input combination of AB? It can be either 00, 01, 10, or 11. Now, corresponding to this input, we need to find what is your next state. See, I will be drawing everything in the same diagram, all the four cases in the same diagram. But if it is possible for you, I will say that you make four different diagrams over here and it will not take much time. So now see very carefully. You can note it down later on. I will give you time. So look, first is what? A equal to 0, B equal to 0. Okay, before that, let me show you one more thing. This is what? This is your NOR gate. Now, if one of the input of NOR gate is 0 and we don't know what is another input, okay, we don't know what is another input, we cannot comment decisively about your output. It will be X complement. So, what is it? X can be anything. It can be 0. It can be 1. But decisively, I cannot make a comment that what will be output. But if for the same NOR gate, if one of my input is what, instead of the 0, if the input is 1, I can decisively make a comment, X can be anything. It can be 0, it can be 1, okay, it doesn't matter, output will be 0. So remember, in NOR gate, 1 is at high priority. Whenever you get 1, you can decisively say that your output is what? Your output will be 0. So keep this thing in mind. So now, when we put A equal to 0, B equal to 0. Now it is advisable that you use different diagrams, but then it is up to you if you want to use or not. If you want to make or not. So when this is 0, what will happen over here? This is also 0, obviously, because these are the inputs. So now I need to check what is your another input of this first and second NOR gate respectively. So this is what? This is Qn, and this is what? This is Qn complement, because it is latched. So your next state will be what? Next state, if you see, that will be 0 plus Qn complement, whole complement. So that is Qn. And this will be what? This will be equal to 0 plus Qn complement. So this is what? This is Qn. So you can see over here that this is coming out to be Qn and this is coming out to be Qn complement. And just now we have discussed that this state is known as your hold state. This state is known as your hold state. If you have any doubts in this, you can ask me. Or else note this down. Whatever I have said up to this point, this, and whatever I have done. Note. Okay, fine. So now next input configuration is what? It is 0. So this is 0. This is 1. So you can see input of the second NOR gate is 1. So if this is 1, immediately, even without looking at this input, I can make a comment that output of the second NOR gate will be 0. And if this is 0, this is latched to your first input, means input of the first NOR gate. So immediately 0 plus 0 complement, this will be what? 1, and this is already 0. Okay, so now you are getting what? You are getting 1 and you are getting 0 over here. Okay, this is 1, this is 0. It's okay, it will go on. So this is what? This is your set state. So tell me, is this clear? Any doubt in this? that how I got this one as 1-0 in set state. So quickly note it down. Now look, next time A is 1, B is 0. So if this is 1, I don't need to wait for this input. Immediately I can say that over here it will be 0, and this 0 is latched over here, so this will come out to be 1. Okay, this is 0, this is 1. So 0, 1, this we know, this is what, this is your reset state. Okay, this is your reset state. So note it down. See, I will look in this present state output whenever I cannot make a decisive comment. I cannot make a decisive comment about the output of any one of the NOR gate. Like in the first case, I couldn't make a decisive comment, so I had to take help of the present state to get the next state. Okay. Okay, fine. So the next input set is what? It is 1, 1. So now when this is 1, 1, I don't need to wait. Immediately I can say that this will be 0, even this will be 0. But you can see this input means this output is normal and this is complemented. How can normal and complemented be the same? So this is 0, 0 coming out, and this is what? This is your invalid state. Okay. This is your what? This is your invalid state. Tell me if this is clear or not. Is this clear? Is this clear? Everyone tell me. Okay. Fine. Fine. So now very important one thing I will say. So out of this AB, listen very carefully what I am asking first. So out of this AB, AB is what? It is your input of this SR latch. So I am asking, out of this AB, in which input, when I apply 1, my latch goes to set state? Look very carefully, in out of AB, in which input, if I apply 1, my latch is going to set state. B, obviously this is your set state, this is B. So this B input is called set input, and obviously if B is set, then A will be reset. And you can even confirm in which input out of AB, if I apply 1, my flip-flop or my latch goes to reset state. You can see reset state is over here. If you apply 1 to A, then you are going to reset state. Now don't say, sir, here also we are applying 1, but that is invalid state. Okay. So this is your reset input. So one very, very important concept, sometimes in question they don't mention which is your set input and which is your reset input. So always remember, in case of SR latch, set input is opposite to Qn plus 1 complement. Always remember, in SR latch, set input is opposite to Qn plus 1 complement. So if you know set input, obviously there are only two input in your SR latch. So if one of them is set, another will be reset. Okay. So is this clear up to this point? Tell me. Is this clear? Any doubt? Any doubt, anyone? So very quickly let me know, or else copy this concept, that what is set, what is reset, and whatever I have explained you. Clear, everyone? Okay. So let us move to then SR latch using NAND gate. Okay, fine. So again, let me mark over here what A B. And last time what I had taken, okay. Fine. So now before starting the circuit, let me show you one thing. That in your NAND gate, if one of the input is 1, if one of the input of NAND gate is 1, I cannot say decisively what will be your output, as your input depends on your other input. Sorry, your output depends on your other input. You can see over here, if x is 0, this will be 1. If x is 1, this will be 0. So you can see what, that I cannot make a decisive comment about the output of NAND gate. But if in the same place one of the input is 0 and another input is x, so I can definitely say that your output will be what? It will be 1. I can make what? I can make a decisive comment that your output is going to be 1 when any one of the input of NAND gate is 0. Okay, when any one of the input of the NAND gate is 0, output will be 1. Now remember, in NAND gate, 0 has more priority. Okay, 0 has more priority. Just give me a minute. Okay, so I was telling what? In SR latch, I'm sorry, in NAND latch, okay, 0 is at high priority. Okay, 0 is at high priority. Now look very carefully. The input combinations can be again 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. See over here, last time when we had discussed your NOR latch, I told you what? That 1 is at high priority. Okay, 1 is at high priority. And in positive logic, in Boolean algebra, 1 corresponds to what? Normal variable. Okay, normal variable. But here you can see what? Here you can see what? That 0 is at higher priority and 0 corresponds to what? Complemented variable. Okay. So now keep this thing in mind and let us move ahead. So look over here. If you see over here, what do you see? That when you apply 0, so 0 means what? 0 in your NAND latch implies that you are giving input to both the NAND gates. Okay, because 0 is at higher priority. When you give 0, you can get a decisive output about the NAND gate. So that is why 0 is considered as giving input over here. Okay, 0 is considered as giving input over here. So 0 has higher priority than 1. So another way of saying this is that 0 is means in this NAND latch, okay, in this NAND latch, it is basically following negative logic. Means 0 corresponds to giving input and 1 corresponds to giving no input. Okay, but let us not go into that much complexity. Just understand that whenever you give 0, that means you are giving a decisive input to your NAND gate. So whenever this is 0, both the outputs are going to be 1, 1. So 1, 1 means what? This is your invalid state. See, last time when you gave 1, 1, A and B equal to 1, 1, you were getting invalid state and the states were 0, 0. Look over here, last case. But here, whenever you give 0, 0, your outputs are 1, 1, that is invalid state. See, now the next is what? Next you can see A is 0 and B is 1. So when you give this as 0, immediately this will be 1, and if this is 1, this will be latched over here. Okay, and this 1 will come and this will be 0. So this is what? This is 1, 0, and this is doing what? This is set state. Okay, this is what? This is your set state. This is your set state. So this is what now? 1, 0. So A 1, B 0. So you can see at this point input B means the input of the second NAND gate is supplied with 0. So immediately this will be 1. If this is 1, this 1 will be latched over here and this will become 0. So this is now 0, 1, and this is what? This is your reset state. Okay, this is your reset state. So the last is what? When we give 1, 1 to your both the NAND gate. So when we give 1, 1, what will happen? Basically, we cannot make a decisive comment about this output. So basically, your present state is Qn complement over here, and this is Qn. So this will come over here, Qn, and this will go over here. So if you solve this, this will be Qn. And this will be Qn complement. So this is what? This is your hold state. Tell me if there is any doubt in this. Any doubt? In this? Any doubt? Anyone? Okay. So now here the concept, it is a little bit twisted. Okay. So either you can take the twisted concept if you want to be good student. Or I have done what? I have actually means done something over here. You will understand that it is logically wrong. You won't find it in any textbook, but it will give you the correct answer. See, here let me ask you. First, let me erase all this thing. See, here 0 corresponds to giving input. Okay, 0 corresponds to giving input. So let me ask you, in which of the input out of A and B, when I give 0, it goes to set state, the latch goes to set state. Out of A, B, in which of the input, if I give 0, my latch goes into set state? Tell me. Once again, I am repeating. Out of input AB, listen very carefully. Out of input AB, in which of the input, when I give 0, the latch goes into set state? Obviously, you can see set state is achieved over here. Now, why am I searching for zeros over here? Because NAND has higher affinity towards 0. Because if we have 0, immediately I can say that your output will be 1. I don't even need to check what? Check your another input what it is. So that is why I am taking 0. So over here, basically, we are getting set. When you apply the set input as 0, we are getting set state when we apply A input as 0. So that is why this is known as set of the latch along with the bar. Why? Because 0 corresponds to complemented variable, and if this is set latch bar, so obviously this will be RL bar. Okay. So here we have the concept of set bar and reset bar due to the fact that in NAND latch 0 has more priority compared to your 1. Tell me if this is clear or not. Is this clear, everyone? So this is your concept of textbook. In every textbook, you are going to find this. Okay, in every textbook, you are going to find this. So you can see what set of the latch complement. It is always opposite to your normal output. Now, this might seem tricky sometime. Okay. So let us do what? Remove all this thing. Just tell me in which input, if we apply one, we get set. In which input? So this is textbook, standard textbook. Everywhere you are going to find this. Okay. Now this concept, what I am telling you, you won't find it in any textbook. So I am asking out of AB, in which input, if I give one, you get set state. You can see if I give one, so I am getting set. Obviously, if this is set, this will be reset. So once again, I have broken the concept into the concept of your NOR gate. Just give me one more minute. Okay. So what I told, I have once again nullified this concept that in NAND gate also 0 is at high priority. I assumed that 1 is at high priority. So again, you can see I have introduced the concept of set reset instead of reset bar set bar. Okay. So instead of set bar reset bar, I have just introduced the concept of simple set reset. So again, you can see set input in your SR latch using NAND gate, it is opposite to Qn plus 1 complement. So from even this relation, you can get back to what is the relation that is given in your textbook. See, if you take complement both sides, so Qn plus 1, it is means opposite to this, you will have set input. Okay. You will have set input. So again, if you take complement of complement, that will be normal variable. So any one of the following you can remember. Okay. This concept I am going to use very significantly in your flip-flops. Okay. Flip-flop. Everywhere I will be using this. So remember, in your NOR latch, set input is opposite to complemented output. Even in your NAND latch, your set input is opposite to your complemented output. Okay. Is this clear? Any doubt, anyone? If you want to ask, you can ask me. Okay. Are we understanding this concept? Did we understand, everyone? Everybody, please respond. Means only Bhumika is understanding. See, I hate this thing. Okay. If you guys don't respond, I really hate that, because a class should be interactive. Okay. In online, I cannot see your face. Even you cannot see my face, but the classes should be interactive. Okay. So now we have the most important concept, that first we are going to study what? We are going to study the flip-flop. So how is a flip-flop different from a latch? Can anyone tell me? Now, by looking at the circuit diagram, you will say that there is something known as clock. Okay. In your flip-flop, there we have clock, and in latch, we don't have clock. So why does this clock plays an important role in any circuit? Can you guys tell me? Why does this clock plays an important role? See, in any kind of circuit, there are basically numerous number of latches, like in your computer. Means we cannot even count how many latches there might be. Okay. So if we give input, same input to different latches, Now it is possible that those latches may generate output after different time, because all this NOR gate, NAND gate, NOR gate, they might not be identical, and they will have what? They will have a finite propagation delay, and they might not be identical also. So what will happen? Output will be produced at different time instant. So we don't require that. So basically, with the help of clock, we are synchronizing the latches so that they give your output at the same instant. So with the help of your clock, we are synchronizing the latches, okay? And when we use clock in a latch, it becomes your flip-flop. Tell me if this is clear or not. So this is the basic difference between latch and flip-flop, that in flip-flop, we basically use a clock circuit, and the clock circuit is used for synchronization of all the latches that are present in the circuit, okay? So now let us study what is your SR flip-flop using NOR latch. Okay, NOR latch. Now you might be telling, sir, why have you used AND gates over here? You can use what? You can use NOR gate only. Yes, we can use NOR gate, but that will do what? That will increase the complexity of the circuit. So due to that fact, I have used AND gate over here. Okay, I don't want to use, means I don't want to replace this AND gate with three more NOR gate. Okay, fine. So now look over here. We have what? We have your SR flip-flop using NOR latch. So again, your input combinations can be what? It can be AB. This will be Qn plus 1 complement. Okay. And here we are going to write your state. Okay. We are going to write the state of the flip-flop. So now look, okay, so I forgot to make a table for clock. So if clock is 0, okay, if clock is 0, so AB can be anything, okay, it can be don't care. Don't care means what? Either it can be 0, it can be 1. But if clock is 0, what will happen? Output of this AND gate will be 0. And we have seen, whenever we give 0, 0 input to SR latch using NOR gate, output is in hold state. So AB can be anything. This will be Qn complement. And this is what? This is hold state. So if clock is not applied, clock is not given, this will be 0. Next is what? If clock is 1 and input is 0, 0, clock 1, input is 0, 1, clock is 1, input is 1, 0. Clock is 1 and input is 1, 1. Okay. So again, when AB is 0, this will be 0, 0. Again, this will be in hold state. Hold. Now, this is looking very simple at the moment, but just wait till the next class. This will be very difficult to understand. Okay. So now look, if A is 0, B is 1. So if A is 0, B 1, so clock is already 1, so this will be 0, this will be 1. Now if this is 1, we know what in your NOR latch, basically opposite to complemented output, we have set input and this is reset. So So set is 1, reset is 0. So obviously this is going to be 1, 0 over here, and this is set state. Now look, if A equal to 1 and B equal to 0. So if this is equal to 1, output of this AND gate will be 1 and output of this will be 0. You can see reset input has 1 in this latch and set input has 0. So obviously this is going to do what? It is going to reset the latch. So over here this will be 0, 1. And in the last state, you can see if both the A and B are 1, what will happen? If both these are 1, 1, so 1, 1, obviously set, reset, both of the inputs are 1 in this NOR latch. So this will make your output go in your invalid state. So tell me if this is clear to you or not. Is this clear? Is this clear? So I should have written over here, reset of the latch and set of the latch. Okay, this is reset of the latch, this is set of the latch. Now let me ask you, this is your overall SR flip-flop. Okay, this is your SR flip-flop using NOR latch. Now tell me, out of A, B, which is set input and which is reset input, out of this A and B, which is set, which is reset? Can you tell me? Out of A, B, which is set, which is reset? Means, are you people not understanding? B set. Okay. So, Shruti is telling that B is set, A is reset. So, very good. Look for set state. So set state is over here. So out of A, B, if in B I apply 1, so this goes to your set state. And similarly, if this is set, obviously A is going to be reset. So always remember that in your SR flip-flop using NOR latch, opposite to complemented output, we have set input of flip-flop. Set input of flip-flop is opposite to the complemented output. Okay, so this is very important, very very important. Okay, fine. So now tell me if this is clear to you or not. Everyone tell me if this is clear. Bhumika, is this clear to you? Okay, fine. So now let us move to SR flip-flop using NAND latch. Okay, see, this will be a little bit conceptual. It's okay. Let us keep it that way. Okay. So I told you what, for this latch, opposite to complemented, we have set of the latch. So I will not be writing comp means set latch bar. I will be simply taking the simple concept, and this will be reset latch. Now, if you want to take what? If you want to take the textbook concept, so this will be what? This will be reset latch and this will be set latch. Okay, so here applying input means what? Applying input means that you are giving 0, but that is a tricky concept, so we are not going to use that. Simple, we are going to use this concept only. Now let us see what are the possible combinations of AB along with the clock. Okay, so clock can be 0, then AB can be don't care, clock 1, 1, 1, 1, this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So again you can see, if clock is 0, so what will happen if clock is 0? So immediately this will be 1, 1, okay, this will be 1, 1, and if input to your NAND latch is 1 1, we go where? We go to your hold state. So this will be QN complement, and this is hold state. Now see, next is what? Clock is 1, but A is 0, B is 0. Same thing again, this will be what? This will be 1 1. So obviously this is going where? This is going to be in your hold state. Now look over here, A is 0, B is 1. So if A 0, B 1, so immediately what will happen? This is 1 into 1, so and means NAND, this will be 0, and if this is 0, this will be 1. So you can see reset input 0, reset of the latch is 0, and set of the latch is 1. So this will push the complete flip-flop to your set state. Okay, this will push to set state. Next is what? Next you can see, clock is 1, A is 1, and B is 0. So A 1, B 0 means what? This will be 0. This will be 1. So whenever set input 0 and reset input 1, your latch will go into your reset state, or the combined flip flop will go to reset state. So that will be 0, 1, and this is reset state. And the last case is what? When we apply 1, 1 to both the 1, 1 to both the inputs AB. So this will be 0, this will be 0, this will push the flip-flop in invalid state, and in invalid state using NAND latch we get what? We get your 0, 0, so this will be what? This will be 1, 1, okay, this will be 1, 1. Tell me if this is clear to you guys or not, if this is clear to you guys or not, is this clear everyone? So now tell me out of AB, which is set input, which is reset input. So again check or set state. You can see whenever you apply I to B, so that is pushing the flip-flop to set, and this is reset. See, for the last all cases, all the three cases, SR latch means SR latch using NOR gate, SR latch using NAND gate, SR flip-flop using NOR gate, okay. So we were getting the set input opposite to complemented output, but for the first time we are getting set input is opposite to non-complemented output, and this is very important, very very important, okay, very important. Now if you had taken set bar over here, reset bar over here, then also it would have been the same thing. It would have been the same thing over here also. See, this set bar, reset bar, this is the concept of NAND latch. It is not the concept of SR flip-flop. Okay? SR flip-flop, it is not the concept of SR flip-flop. Okay? So still you will get the same concept. Only for that latch, we have the concept of set latch bar and reset latch bar, but I don't want to use it. Okay, I don't want to use it. We every place we are using what? We are using set, and in all the cases I have told you that giving one is actually giving input. Only thing you need to remember is that in NAND 0 has high priority, in NOR 1 has high priority. Tell me if in this any doubt, anyone, any doubts? Okay, so now do what? Let us do the truth table for SR flip-flop. See, in any kind of circuit, we will not be said that SR flip flop using NAND, SR flip flop using NOR. Okay, in the questions it will not be given. So we need a generalized truth table for your combined NOR flip flop, means SR flip flop using NOR and SR flip flop using NAND. So the combined truth table, let us try to get it. Okay, combined truth table. So here we have what? Clock. Clock A, B, or you can even say, now this time I will be writing it as set reset input, and over here state. Okay, state I will be writing. Okay, present state I for means next state I forgot to write. Qn plus 1, Qn plus 1 complement, and over here state. Okay, state. So let me make the columns. Either clock can be 0. So it doesn't matter what is set reset. Or clock can be 1, input is 00, clock 1, 01, clock 1, 10, clock 1, 11. So now look, whenever clock is 0, it doesn't matter whatever is your set reset in both the flip-flop. Now look at both the table, this table and this table. So clock 0, input doesn't matter, it is directly in your hold state. Okay, hold state. Qn complement hold state. Now look, when set input 0, reset input 0. So set input 0, reset input 0, hold over here in NAND latch, even in your NOR latch, it is in hold state. Okay. So now look, whenever set input 0, reset input 1. So over here, set input 0, where is that? Set input 0, reset input 1, so that is in your reset state. Over here also, when reset is 1, set is 0, it is in reset state. So this will be 0, 1, and this is reset state. Whenever set input 1, reset 0, in both the cases you will be seeing what? Set 1, reset 0, so you get set state. Over here also you get set state. So this will be what? This will be 10 set state. Now look over here. When both S and R are 11. So look, when it is 11, you get invalid state. And over here also you get invalid state. So first write, this is invalid. But look, what is the next state? Over here in invalid, when you apply 11, you are getting invalid. And the states you are getting is 11, and over here you are getting 00. So what should I fill in this table? If I want to fill the generalized truth table, what should I fill over here? 1 or 0? Whether I should fill 11 or should I fill 00? What should I fill over here then? Very quickly tell me. Yes, very good. We should fill neither 11 nor 00. We should fill what? We should fill don't care, don't care. Because it can be either 11 or it can be 00. So it is better that we fill don't care. Okay. So this is the combined truth table of your SR flip-flop. Now next is what? Characteristics table. Now, what is this characteristics table? Basically, characteristics table give you the next state with all the possible combination of input and present state. So, what I told you, characteristics table tell us about the next state when we have all the possible combination of inputs and present state. So, this is input. Sorry, I should have written SR. SR. So these are your inputs along with your, means we need to find what? We need to find the next state. Okay. So the possible combination of input along with your present state will be what? It will be either 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, and last will be 1, 1, 1. So I have all the possible combination of input along with the present state that I can have. See in the first case, what do we have? Set, reset, both of them are 0. So that means your flip-flop is in hold state. It will hold the present state. What is our present state? Present state is 0. So this will be, next state will be also 0 because your flip-flop is in hold state. So in hold state, basically whatever is your present state, same will be in the next state. So this is 0. Again, you can see this is 0. So next state will be hold. So here your present state is 1. So next state will be also 1. See over here, set input 0, reset input 1. So here this is independent of your present state. Directly you can say that your next state will be 0 because your flip-flop is working in your reset input is high. You can see all the places and set input is 0. Here also this will be 0. In this two case, set input is high, reset input is 0. So flip-flop will work in reset state. So this is your reset state. And the last is what? The last you can see, S and R both are 1. So this is invalid state. So invalid state we have already is don't care. So we are going to put don't care over here. Tell me if this is clear to you guys or not. Is this clear, everyone? Is this clear? Clear? Okay. Now, let us try to find the relationship between Qn plus 1. Means, what is the relationship between Qn plus 1 and S, R and Qn? Okay. So, we want to generate a function such that Qn plus 1 is a function of S, R and Qn. So, how can we do that? Let us simply make a K-map, or you can even write the minterms where Qn plus 1 is equal to 1 for the corresponding minterms and reduce it. So for 1 it is 1, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 4, 5, 6, 7 is don't care. Okay. 4, 5 is 6, 7. Don't care. 6, 7 is don't care. Just give me a minute. So look, now let us try to make the group. So you can see I can make one group of 4 like this and one more group like this. So if I write the expression for Qn plus 1, that is equal to what? For this group of 4, S is common, S equal to 1, so that is S. For this 2, R complement Qn. And this is known as your next state equation of SR flip-flop. Very important. So this is next state equation of your SR flip-flop. Is this clear, everyone? How we derived the next state equation of SR flip-flop? Is this clear, everyone? Any doubt? Okay. So next table we have over here is what? Next table we have over here is what? It is your excitation table. Now, what is this excitation table? In excitation table, basically, we take all the combination of present state and next state to make a comment about the input of the flip-flop. Now over here we have SR flip-flop. So we take all the possible combination of present state and next state to make a comment about the input of the SR flip-flop. So this is very important while designing counters. We will be requiring this, okay, synchronous counter. So excitation table means what? Basically, we are seeing your all the combination of present state and next state to make a combination about the input of the flip-flop. So all the combination can be what? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So this excitation table can be filled with the help of your characteristics table. So look over here, where is Qn and Qn plus 1, both of them 0, 0. So at this place you have 0, 0. Any other place we have 0? No. So what is the SR for this? So that is 0, 0. Sorry. Over here also we have 0, 0. Okay. So these two places we have 0, 0. So look, in both the cases, S is 0. So S 0 I am directly writing. But what about R? In one of the cases, R is 0. Another, it is 1. So I will be putting don't here. Okay. I will be putting don't here. Now check where your Qn and Qn plus 1 is 0, 1. So in this place, it is 0, 1. Okay. Any other place that you have 0, 1. Now don't say that, sir, here there will be one possible combination of 0, 1. So here it is don't care. You cannot tell. Okay. Decisively, you cannot tell. You only need to search for the places where you have a, means you can make a decisive comment that where you have 0, 1. So you can see it is 0, it is 1 over here, and the corresponding SR is what? It is 1, 0. So write 1, 0. Next is what? It is 1, 0. So where can you see 1, 0 in Qn and Qn plus 1? So one of the places is over here. Any other place? No. So for this, we have what? We have 0, 1. And the last case is what? It is 1, 1. So 1, 1 we have over here and over here. So S is equal to 0 over here, S equal to 1. So in this place put don't care. And R is what? R is 0 in both the cases. So even this excitation table you need to memorize. Don't worry. Once we finish SR flip-flop, D flip-flop, JK flip-flop, T flip-flop, I will give you a shortcut trick to remember all the excitation table for the four flip-flop. At the moment, you just need to understand this much. Tell me, is this clear? Have you understood what is flip-flop, means SR flip-flop, SR latch, what is characteristics table, equation, excitation table, next state equation? Are all the concepts clear? Is it clear? Okay, fine.